Hello and welcome back to another Friday video where yes, you are automatically getting the second part to my top 10 favorite Star Trek episodes from now 5 to 1. So in case you did not watch Wednesday's episode where I went through 10 to 6, there are a few things to note. Number one, I won't have the original series episodes on this list as I have not watched enough of the original series to add onto this list. Number two, there won't be any modern Star Trek episodes as they are still currently airing. And number three, there will only be one Borg episode that I'm allowing myself to have on this list. Otherwise, it would probably, half of this list would be Borg episodes. So, with that being said, let's dive in to my number five. My number five pick. So, my number five goes to All Good Things, the two-parter that ended off The Next Generation. I think this was a fantastic send-off to an even greater Star Trek show. Yes, I have not seen all of TNG, but from what I have seen, which I'd say it's about 40 to 50% of the show, is that this is one of the best Star Trek shows ever made. It's not the best, you know, my personal favorite Star Trek show is Voyager, but a lot of people do like TNG and Deep Space Nine and all that. But still, the fact that this ends off on the the trial of Q that was set up all the way back in episode one of the show in the Encounter at Farpoint, and that we actually get to, you know, jump between different times, you know, go back to season one with Picard on the Enterprise, bring him back Denise Crosby as Tasha Yar, and actually giving us a first look at Picard's first look at the Enterprise, you know, paying homage to the motion picture with that, and then as well just, you know, being in the present and being in a possible future, you know, seeing the possible future counterparts to everyone, especially the future counterpart of the Enterprise D, which obviously at the end of this episode gets rewritten, because we know in Generations that the Enterprise unfortunately gets destroyed. It seems in nearly every Star Trek movie, an Enterprise gets destroyed. But still, this is a fantastic mystery as well, you know, trying to figure out what's causing this issue, you know, and like figuring out that it doesn't start in the future, but it's, if you keep going backwards and backwards in time, the stronger it gets, and just having Picard slowly figure out what it is and trying to put a stop to it. It's why I love this episode. So yeah, my number five goes to All Good Things, a fantastic send-off to the TNG crew. So number four for me goes to the Star Trek Voyager episode Blink of an Eye. I absolutely love and adore this episode, and it's one that I return to quite a bit, to be quite honest, as it's a really good episode. You know, the fact that Voyager is caught on this planet, that Voyager can actually be seen from the planet, and it kind of influences them in a way. The fact that they managed to, you know, send the Doctor down for a number of years, and he's somehow managed to, you know, not only integrate into their society, but manage to, you know, get married and potentially have kids. I think that's what it was implying. But it's one of the better Voyager episodes out there, and it's why I put it in my number four position. So, we are now cracking the top three. So, what is in my top three? Well, let's see what is the third position. Okay, so number three goes to yesterday's Enterprise from Star Trek: The Next Generation, and it's the last Next Generation episode to feature on this list. Yes, I know I only picked two, but it's my list. Fuck you, it's my list. Anyway, so yeah, yesterday's Enterprise. What a fantastic episode, you know, showing what would have happened had the Enterprise C not been there to be destroyed by the Romulans, thus creating the Kittimer Accords to make peace with the Klingons, and just showing even with the Federation's slightly, you know, continuing to advance their technology, you know, we see the battleship Enterprise with the Galaxy class, that even that isn't enough to defeat Klingons, and just the whole story, you know, hell, even bringing back Denise Crosby for the first time since she was killed off in season one was amazing to see, you know, because I liked Tasha Yar. I still haven't seen her the episode where she dies, though. I've seen clips of it, but yeah. Anyway, this is a fantastic episode, and again, all the actors were amazing in this episode, but mainly Whoopi Goldberg. My God, did she do an amazing job in this episode, you know, trying to convey that this timeline isn't correct, that this isn't right, what they're at right now isn't the right way, and trying to convince them to send the Enterprise C back through the wormhole or the time shift, the time fracture, to in order to set things correct, and then have Tasha Yar, you know, go on, you know, be on that Enterprise as it's going back in time, and you know we think all is good in on that until you know later on when we see Sela. But hey, it's still a fantastic episode, and it's one that I'll always recommend to Star Trek fans and non-Star Trek fans as well, because I have shown this episode to a few non-Star Trek fans, and they love it. They think it's a pretty good episode. So yeah, number three is yesterday's Enterprise. So let's see what number two is. All right, so here is the one and only Borg episode to be on my list, and that is Scorpion Parts 1 and 2. Yes, I chose this over all of the other Borg episodes that are out there, because I genuinely think Scorpions Parts 1 and 2 is the best Borg episode out there. Yes, it is even better than the Best of Both Worlds Parts 1 and 2. I don't even like Best of Both Worlds Parts 1 and 2. I will probably need to do a video on that in the next few months on why I hate it. But anyway, yeah, Scorpion Parts 1 and 2 is what the Best of Both Worlds tried to be. And it just done it better. Like, the stakes are a hell of a lot higher in this. You know, the introduction to species 8472 or 8672, one of the two, the Undine. Well, we'll just call it the Undine because that's the name that was given to them in Star Trek Online, so it's just easier than trying to remember species 8476543 2 1. So yeah, this episode fantastic. Kate Mulgrew, amazing. All the other actors and are amazing, especially with the introduction to Jeri Ryan as 7 of 9, who is just amazing. Her 7 of 9 as a character after this point is pretty darn amazing, and as a first introduction to her character, even as just the Borgified 7 of 9, is pretty darn good. I'm gotta admit, it is pretty good. And just the fact that the Undine are the only thing capable of easily destroying the Borg. Like, hell, I think at one point they destroyed like three or four planets and like a whole armada of Borg cubes and spheres and probes, what have you. They've fucking destroyed it. And like, they're the first species that the Borg just can't assimilate. I mean, again, if you play Star Trek Online, you do know that in beta canon, through Star Trek Online, they have been able to successfully assimilate the Undine, but because we haven't seen it in Alpha Canon, it's non-canon. So the Undine are still like the first species that they haven't been able to assimilate. And just poor Harry. Harry got the fucking worst of it. But anyway, I've rambled on a bit, so let's move on to my number one pick. So yeah, my number one pick goes to the Star Trek Voyager episode Death Wish. This episode is honestly one of the probably the best episodes of Star Trek Voyager that I have ever seen. And you know, hence why it's my number one pick, because it's the best Star Trek episode I have ever seen. It's the best Q episode as well, because you know, with Q episodes, they tend to be hit or miss. You know, some hits, some misses, about equal footing. But this episode, not only did it introduce us to another Q that we know there's more Qs, but I think this is the first time we've seen another Q, or I should start referring to him as Quinn, as that's the name he chose in the end. And it's just the whole legal proceedings of trying to convince Janeway that, you know, Quinn wants to die. It's the only thing left in this universe that he hasn't experienced. He's experienced it all. And the fact that, you know, RQ is the one that we've known through TNG has to prove why he was put into that prison. And you know, it takes for Quinn to remind Q just what he used to be, where he was more defiant towards the Continuum until they had to wrangle him in. And Quinn, you know, was like, "You inspired me to do all these things." And that's what gets to RQ in the end. And it's just a beautiful episode, and it gets you thinking. An awful lot. And I just love this episode. So there you guys go. That has ended my top 10 favorite Star Trek episodes for right now. Let me know what your list is in the comments below, and I will see you all on Monday for another brand new upload.